Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Good evening. This is Pastor Spencer from Messiah Lutheran Church in Salem, Oregon. Today is the 5th of September, Anno Domini 2020, Saturday evening. And tonight our psalm is the 139th psalm. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up, you discern my thoughts from afar. You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, behold, O Lord, you know it altogether. You hem me in behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high, I cannot attain it. Where shall I go from your spirit? Or where shall I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light about me to be night. Even the darkness is not dark to you, the night is bright as day, for the darkness is light with you. For you formed my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. And our prayer for this evening. To you, O God, belong praise and glory for your wonderful providence, that you are present with all your creatures and preserve them in their being. Teach us to remember at all times and all places that your eyes are upon us, and that all our deeds are recorded in your book. Blot out the sins that are past with the blood of Christ, and cause us to walk in your fear, and to avoid sin. In Jesus' holy name, amen. And amen. And tonight we continue with St. Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 9, verses 1 through 3. I speak the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it in the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were cursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my brothers, those of my own race, the people of Israel. Theirs is adoption as sons. Theirs is divine glory, the covenant, the receiving of the law, the temple worship, and the promise. Theirs are the patriarchs, and from them is traced the human ancestry of Christ, who is God over all, forever praised. Amen. I actually went through verse 5. Very interesting passage. I speak the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, God cannot lie. God is truth. God is truth incarnate. The devil is the father of all lies. But St. Paul goes on to say he has great anguish for those that are in the household of Israel. That if he could take their punishment, if he could be as Christ was for us, if he could be propitiation and pay the price for their sin, he would willingly do it. You see, love doesn't consider self first, it considers others. Theirs is adoption as sons. And then he goes on to explain why. The people of Israel, theirs is adoption as sons, theirs is divine glory, the covenants, the receiving of the law, the temple worship, and the promises. And theirs is the patriarchs from whom is traced the human ancestry of Christ. So the people of Israel. The primary focus of Israel was to remain as a pure bloodline, pointing back to that original sin in Adam and the reconciliation that comes in Christ. Jesus' bloodline can be traced all the way back to Adam. It also can be traced back to Abraham, to whom went the promise before he was even a child of Israel. From his seed would come many. And so the bloodlines go back to David, and then back to Abraham, and then back to Adam, showing that Christ's bloodline goes right back to undo the sin of the one man that caused all men to fall, Adam, and that in Christ all men have received atonement, that by the blood of Christ, forgiveness has been obtained. So, the Jewish people were held in special regard for the sake of keeping the bloodline pure. Now the children of Abraham are children by faith, not by bloodlines, but by faith. And that's all for tonight. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you his peace. God's blessings. The peace of the Lord be with you.